said love makes no sense. Don't try to fight it, all your defenses are useless to you now. When you leave this room, all you will think about is me. I'll be every song on your radio, everything on your TV. Just wait and see, even though you never looked at me.
Hey, it's Tom. Again,
call me.
I'll take you by the hand and soon I'll pull your heart out of your body. And there is no way you can escape me. I know the real you is behind those eyes. Every true story is full of lies that lead to the real.
Hi, I'm Eli Wyckoff. I'm here for my test results.
And you're about an hour early. Why don't you go get yourself some coffee?
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna wait, if that's okay.
Okay. This your first time?
My first? No. I have this habit of getting tested after every guy that I ever. Well, there's only been like three in the past few. This is the third, so it's not really a habit yet.
Uh-huh.
Oh, no, it's not like I think there's even a chance that I have, you know. I know the dangers. I do the police blotter for the Hollywood News, so me and Danger were like this.
So why are you here? Feedback clinic, this is Esther. Uh-huh. What, did you suck his dick? Then you better come in. Okay.
Hi, I'm Tom. And I'm an alcoholic.
Hi, Tom.
So, I'm 10 days away from my 30-day chip. Both my parents are drunks, but I still don't feel like I belong here, you know? I mean, I go to flea markets. I vote, even for like school board and prop, whatever. I mean, I'm a special ed teacher, for Christ's sake. It's not like I'm this Hollywood has-been crouched in an airport bathroom sucking on a can of Final Net. So. Why am I here? The truth? Truth is, I met a guy. And if I had to pick a, I don't know, a trigger, you know, I'd have to say it was all over this guy. But whatever, you know what, who cares how it happened? Bottom line is, I'm here. And I quit drinking and guys because I can't be trusted with either. Thanks.
Where's it going?
Oh. Yeah, well, I'll get it right one of these times.
It's not right to me. It's like you were telling my story.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I shared first, so I get dibs on the book rights.
That's fair.
So tell me about the guy.
You know what? No, I don't want to keep you from...
What? From what?
The important things in life like stapling or filing?
Oh, please, I couldn't be more bored.
So the thing with that guy, you seem pretty healthy with it.
Only to the sight and hearing impaired.
Pull up your chair, honey.
This one?
Yeah. So, you and your boyfriend, you broke up.
Oh, boyfriend, I don't know.
I don't know, but things just got too, you know? And I choked, I'm an alcoholic, you do the math.
We met on a blind date, which sucked. Then we became friends, and now we don't speak to each other. So, it's a happy ending.
How do we meet? It all started with this phone call from my best friend, Jackie.
Tom, pick up.
Damn it, where are you? I'm at a payphone because I can't get my piece of shit cell phone to work unless I'm standing on my head with my fingers up my ass. Fuck you! Anyway, listen. What are you doing Friday night? Because I just met this guy, Brett, at a furniture store in Montana, and he showed me this great love seat to die for, and I think I could get it wholesale. There's just one catch.
Everything I want, you got it. Everything I need, you own it. Everything I need, you got it. Everything in me, you own it. Everything I want, you got it. Everything I need, you own it. Everything I need, you got it. Everything in me, you own it.
Any luck?
Oh, with?
Oh, I don't know. I just figured by now you'd be looking for change beneath the seat cushions.
Oh God, you saw me.
Oh yeah, no, the whole routine, the little dance.
Oh, that's great. Now I'm thoroughly mortified.
No, you're fine. Don't worry about it.
Well, I know, but now it's your turn to do something humiliating.
Oh well, I work in a furniture store, so I'm pretty much covered those bases.
Well, hello, hey, what's humiliating about an employee discount, right? Which, by the way, does that apply to this sort of wheelie carty thing? Because this is yummy.
Right. Look, A, I get 10% off of this crap. And B, you know, I don't know if the whole Clockwork Orange come IKEA thing is really your scene, honestly.
Quite a salesman.
Yeah, I don't even know what half this shit is. So.
Okay. Great. Well, you know what, though? My heart does kind of beat faster for this love seat.
Oh, you're kidding.
Why? Do you hate it?
No, I know. It's the only thing in the store that's mine.
Yours?
One of my designs, yeah.
Oh, your designer.
Yeah, no, this is one of my first projects.
Well, I love it.
Thank you.
What is the color? Sort of a yellow, beige, yellow?
Buttercup.
Buttercup?
Buttercup. I'm not gay, okay? Just because I say butter, you know, I have this argument with Eli all the time. God damn it, man. You know, I don't know, just because I say butter doesn't mean I'm gay, you know, or used to be gay or want to be gay. Not gay, you know, just very particular about the nomenclature I use regarding my palate.
And who's Eli, the boyfriend?
Right. No, he's my, you know, he's my best friend. You know, happens to be gay.
Well, you know what I think? I think you're one of those guys who, you know, sort of flirts with a girl, maybe even takes her to dinner, and then, you know, when push comes to shove, the only Frenching you'll be doing with her are her braids.
Wow, that's pretty sassy. Yeah. You've been braided a lot recently.
No, I know gay men, okay? I practically invented them.
Okay.
You know, and there's no such thing as a straight guy with a gay best friend. He's not fucking. Hey, don't give me that look, all right? My friend Tom, who, by the way, is single, if you're interested. Yeah, he's the first to agree.
Right. Okay. Well, thanks for the tip. I'm not particularly interested in Tom. Well, unless, of course, he has your eyes.
So, there's actually a chance that he didn't hate my guts and I could be having his children on that kick-ass buttercup love seat, which is where you come in.
I was like, great. I figured next she'd be asking me to blow some guy for 3-day blinds.
You know in the movies, when a guy's in the supermarket and he accidentally bumps shopping carts with the love of his life?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, the last few times I bumped carts with anyone, they looked like they were fresh off the special bus. That is why I let my friends fix me up.
Hi, this is Eli. Leave a message.
Oh, that's right. There's an X-Files marathon on. I cannot believe I'm friends with a Trekkie. It's pathetic.
Okay, I am not a Trekkie, you got that? I just like the X-Files. I believe the truth is out there, don't you?
Yeah, whatever. Look, man, I fully hooked you up. You have a date on Friday night.
Wait a minute. What?
Yep, that's right. Your losing streak is over, my man. He's a tall stud, like a big guy.
Okay, you always say that. It's like entry level. It means he's got nipples.
Yeah, for you, that'd be a step up.
That's
anyway,
fine.
Look, his friend Jackie came into the store. Completely hit it off. Yikes. Let me tell you, she's got unbelievable KB.
What is that? Killer butt?
No. Killer boobs. Anyway, she told me about her friend Tom. Sounds like a nice guy. I lied, basically. Said you were a great guy. I told her about you.
That's really
and,
nice.
And now you two have to go out on Friday night.
Okay, wait a minute. Says who? Let's
actually, you know what? Can I call you right back? I just showed up at my loser gay friend's place. I'll call you back.
It's fine.
It's mainly John. Anyway, look, I know it didn't go also, you know, that well the last time with, Richard, was it? Rita from UPS? She was a woman. Whatever, you know, she was still gay. You know, that's your problem. You're so picky. Anyway, you yourself said she had KB.
Killer boobs?
No, but.
Okay, you know, the whole initial thing, it's gotta stop. And P.S., I never said KB, I said KGB. Killer garlic breath.
No. Whatever. No. The bottom line is, I made a reservation for you. For Tom, Friday night, at Nick's, 8 o'clock, be there, be square.
Okay, you know, I hate it when people say that, because even when I'm there, I'm square, so where's the incentive?
Well, he's a teacher. Sounds like a great guy. Maybe you got lucky, you have to stay after class, right? Detention? You like that sort of thing,
really
don't
funny,
you?
Yeah.
The discipline, the gravity boots, the whole thing? You're welcome.
Of course, you went.
Yep, I went. Believe me, I didn't have high hopes for this date.
But you didn't have anything to lose.
I know. Honestly, all I kept thinking was, I hope he doesn't smoke. Sometimes I wish I had a gun. I'm gonna go up to the bar and get another drink. You want something?
Yes, I'll have another seltzer with lime.
Seltzer with lime?
Make it a white wine spritzer.
Spritzer, got it.
On second thought, can I get a 7-7? Rocks with a twist.
Okay, are you sure?
Yeah. I always get a 7-7.
Oh, hi. Yeah. We're going to have a...
Absolute martini, straight up, 2 olives. Make it a little dirty. You?
You like movies?
Yeah, I like movies.
Yeah, me too. I think it was gay night on cable last night because In-N-Out was on again.
Uh-huh.
No, I just thought it was great, you know, to see a movie like that with two guys. Not with two guys, you know, but with two guys who, you know, in the movie.
I hated it.
Oh, yeah, no, me too. I just thought it was light. Fun.
Fun?
Yeah.
Fun to see Kevin Kline get on his sorry-ass middle-aged knees and give us a big old Hollywood blowjob by catering to every cliched, homophobic, stereotypical idea of what it means to be gay without
having the decency or the courtesy or even just the balls to drop a little trowel and show us his.
Wait a minute, come on. I don't know, I thought it was nice to see a guy coming out to his family, his friends, not to mention his fiancée.
His fiancée? The loser bitch has been waiting her whole life to marry this Nelly, barber-loving, self-hating, geriatric English teacher who can't get it up for her, and we're supposed to feel sorry for her? Aww. No fucking way. I mean, you do the math. The hell is the waiter with my drink? You want anything?
Not even gonna mention Birdcage.
You gonna Diet Coke?
Sure.
All right. What was your favorite movie of all time? Let's just start with that.
You know what? I'm not a big fan of the favorites game, so why don't you go first?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Okay. Well, I know it sounds corny and cliche, but I have to say Gone with the Wind.
I never saw it.
Yeah, right.
I didn't. I never saw Gone with the Wind.
You're kidding, right?
No. I'm not kidding.
Come on.
I never saw the movie.
You never saw the movie?
No, I never... Okay, fine. Do you want me to tell you that I saw the movie? I will. I saw the movie. It was the best movie I've ever seen. Especially that part where Red Buttons is up on the hill with Charlotte.
Oh my God, you are scaring me.
Wait, what do you want me to say? I'm not a big fan of black and white movies. Relax, would you relax? I saw Fam like 15 times. Does that help?
Well, it's a start. Wow, K.E.
What?
What?
What did you just say?
Nothing.
No, you just said something.
No, I didn't.
No, you did. You said K.E. What is that?
It's nothing. It's nothing. It's stupid. It's initial talk. Brett and I have been doing it for years. It is so stupid, it means nothing. Trust me.
Great, so I just took a hit.
No, you didn't. Tom, believe me. I swear to you. Oh. It means killer eyes, okay?
You know what? I'm gonna go. It's late, and
yeah, let's you and I go on our way, ways on our way, separate, you and me, you know. Here, let's split it.
No, I got it.
No, let's split it.
No, I want to do this.
Please, I don't want to do that.
Just let me pay.
Let me just split it.
Just let me do this.
Let me just pay for my.
Just go.
Going.
He hated me. It was like I activated his gag reflex. That is the last time I let you fix me up. You got that? Take it in.
Next date I go on is gonna cost me $2 for the first minute and $1.50 traditional minute.
Did you say anything about me and Jackie?
What? No, it didn't come up. Are you sure the guy was even gay?
Are you kidding?
I don't know. You know, with you,
How many straight guys you know pretend they're gay?
Besides you.
Hello. You sure didn't say anything about me.
Hey, do you want eggs? I can easily add an egg to this. You want an egg?
Can I have eggs? Are there eggs? Are there eggs?
Yeah.
You have to relax. You're becoming a crazy person. You've been whipping for 20 minutes. Your mother told me you're gonna be like this.
My mom called you again? What did you tell her?
No, but she's concerned about you. You never talk to the woman, you know? She thinks you're becoming a big loser.
Oh, that's nice. That's great. Thanks for that. It's easy for her to say. I know what's out there. Guys with bad fucking hair plugs, staples in their dicks, Beanie Baby collections, or worse.
Worse?
Oh, there's worse.
Oh, come on. It'll be so much better next time.
There won't be a next time. Unless his name is Ben, Jerry, Jose Cuervo.
Uh-huh. Like you haven't already had those guys. And they're brothers. Haven't you ever wondered what it's like to be with the same guy for more than, oh, I don't know, 5 minutes?
I mean, the guys I meet, 5 minutes is all it takes.
Charming. Okay, but more importantly, what did Eli say about me? Is it gonna happen with Brett?
No idea, didn't mention it.
Like I care. But maybe I should call Brett and just, you know, find out what Eli said about your date.
Couldn't care less.
Right. We officially don't care. I get it. Yeah. I definitely am not going to call.
Where are you going?
Home. To officially not call.
No. You were supposed to stay here and watch Lifetime Television for women and gay men.
No.
It's Joan Van Ark and Not Without My Nose, Joan.
Oh, Angel, I've already lived that movie.
All that shit people say about finding the one, I'm sick of it. Tom certainly isn't. I don't ever think I'm gonna meet the guy who is.
You know, your whole problem is there's no such thing as the one, okay?
You're such a liar. Like 2 seconds ago, you told me how you think this girl Jackie is the one.
I met her one time. I said she could be the one, you know, or one of the ones. There's not just one. You know, there's fractions of ones. There's halves of ones, quarters of ones. You know, the idea is about making yourself open to someone, you know, perhaps Tom becoming the one.
Are you coming to the flea market with me tomorrow?
No, sweetie, by tomorrow, I'm hoping to actually have plans with a man who'll appreciate me for my body, okay, not just my brains and wit and sense of style.
So Dad's in town?
You're disgusting. Mwah. Why don't you take a date to the flea market?
Oh.
Okay, that is why you never go steady.
I haven't gone steady since the 7th grade. You do the math.
Besides, he kept saying you do the math, even when it made no sense. Like, what a turnoff.
Yeah, what's the turn on? According to your mother, you haven't had a hard-on since she first took you to see the Nutcracker at the Jewish Community Center in the 1st grade.
Talking to mother about my sex life?
What sex life?
I have one.
Uh-huh.
Okay, you know, it counts.
Right.
I spent 10 years learning which buttons to push. Now I just have to look at myself when I come.
Ew.
Good.
You
look good. God.
Thanks.
No, really.
So, what, you were lying the first time?
What? No. You got that fresh Sunday morning, read the paper, cup of coffee kind of look.
God, here I thought I had that stale Sunday morning hangover, choke on my own vomit thing going.
What are you here for? You looking for anything in particular?
Yeah, actually, I'm looking for a vintage martini set. You know, the shaker and the glasses, the whole thing.
Huh.
How about you? You just browsing?
Me? Are you kidding? I go nuts. I have to look for one thing and just one thing.
Mm-hmm. And that would be what?
A bathroom, actually. Shit, they probably don't have bathrooms at a place like this, right? Probably just porta potties. God, I hate those. You know, my parents had to rent like 4 of them for my sister's bat mitzvah.
Come on, you didn't come here looking for a bathroom.
I didn't. Okay, I'm looking for an original Cornelius action figure. You know, from Planet of the Apes.
What, you're yanking my chain, right?
Yeah, actually, no, I'm not, and I really hate that expression, but you know, it was good seeing you. I'll see you around.
No. Come on, grow a sense of humor, will you? I'm not, you're funny. I'm not laughing at you. No, not funny bad, you're funny good. Funny good, look. Why don't we go grab a cup of coffee and then I'll help you go look for your dolly.
Action figure.
So is it just the apes or do you have Betsy Wetsy too? Because Jackie didn't tell me that you were a doll collector.
Interesting, you know, Brett didn't tell me you were an asshole.
Speaking of which, what's up with those two?
So, I thought you should know they hated each other.
Oh, right, more than life itself, yeah.
No fucking chemistry.
Hello?
I had the biggest Planet of the Apes collection till like the sixth grade when my parents made me sell it at a garage sale. They were afraid it was gonna adversely affect my psychosexual development. They're both shrinks.
Oh, did it?
What?
Affect your psycho whatever?
Well, I'm gay, aren't I?
Oh, so the apes made you gay?
I don't know.
What is that, the ape theory?
Well, you've got a half-naked Charlton Heston in a cage.
Where he belongs.
Yeah, right. Plus my huge crush on Roddy McDowell. And those cute little leather outfits. That, my friend, is a gay preteen happy meal.
Do you have any martini sets?
Oh, right now.
You know, I gotta admit, I don't even know what a martini set looks like. I wouldn't know a martini if it bit me in the ass.
No, I shouldn't if you know how to make them.
I take it you do.
In my house, you had to. I couldn't tie my shoes till I was 10, but I can make a martini. I was like Isaac on our sinking little love boat.
Thank you, sweetheart. This is perfect. So, Tommy, have you met any nice girls at school this year?
Yeah, they're nice.
Earth, you give any thought to what we talked about?
None of the other fifth graders know what they're going to do after high school.
Well, I care about a bunch of pansy fifth graders with silver spoons in their mouths.
I sort of like the idea of teaching. Teaching sounds good.
That's terrific, honey.
I can't remember them without a drink in their hand. You know, when my father used to pitch baseballs to me in the backyard, he never spilled a drop.
Oh my God, I can't even imagine.
Your parents didn't drink?
No, we never played games in the backyard.
Never?
Well, first of all, we didn't have a backyard. And second of all, the closest we ever came to a game was the feel wheel.
Rage is at the top. Then we move down to frustration, confusion, loneliness. On the other side, we have loving, affectionate.
Silly!
Okay, Eli, you go first.
Take your name and put it on the emotion you're feeling right now.
That's right, Eli. Don't think. Look inside. What are you feeling?
Right now, go.
Don't think. Go. Go. Go!
Do I have to, Dr. Wyckoff?
Can you do it for Mommy?
You'd just be walking along, and then you think, gee, I feel happy, and you'd put your little flag on the wheel?
No, it was just something my parents wanted us to do so that they would feel more enlightened. Like getting us to say penis and vagina at the dinner table. You know, so that we'd feel comfortable talking about sex, which is probably why now I prefer pee-pee and hoo-hoo.
More pee-pee than hoo-hoo, I'd imagine.
Does it show?
I don't think that game would have been a hit in my house. Unless there was a section on the wheel for thirsty.
Well, there was a section on the wheel for scared. But you'd have had to share that one with me.
Hey, no chance on the Eli and Tom thing, huh? That's...
Ugh, what a pain. The gays are so picky.
No. It's Eli. I'm telling you, he's got the worst DK on the planet.
Donna Karen?
No. Dating karma. Yeah, no, it sucks. Yeah, he told me that A, he thinks he, like, insulted Tom 100 times, and B, that he's, you know, straight. Yeah.
Okay, so no. Tom is just a freak. You know, he officially hates any guy that he likes. Or worse, who likes him.
What, dude?
Yeah, well, welcome to the wonderful world of self-hate. And he's not even Jewish.
What on God's earth is this? I mean, honestly, that's the ugliest thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
What's the hurry?
Oh, you know what? Today's decoupage day at school, and I'm late, so...
Oh, okay.
Listen, I just... I want to apologize for yesterday and last night. It shouldn't happen.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we got off to a really good start, but then I feel like I
fuck things up. So I promise it won't ever happen again.
Good. Yeah, we shouldn't have. Anyway, it was both of our faults, so.
No, so, you know, let's just pretend it never happened.
Perfect.
Great. All right. And I'll see you later.
Great time. I don't get it.
Look to me like you did get it. Something called laid.
You know, FYI,
yeah.
Gay guys don't necessarily play the same basses that straight guys do.
I'm still fucking, dude.
Hello, gentlemen.
You don't mind if the brother hangs out, do you? I had him fixed.
Do I have a choice? I don't get the double standard. You know, guys can do all kinds of things with women, and they won't call it sex unless they actually fuck. You know, like sex with interns.
Listen, I don't know. I'm not judging you. You know, it's just sex, man.
No, I'm not being defensive. I'm trying to explain to you that a guy can get together with another guy and do all kinds of things without necessarily, you know...
Right. That's enough.
It's a big step. I know couples who have never and probably will never actually...
Empty. New topic.
What is with you? You were never this squeamish in college.
It's because you were dating women.
Yeah, well, it's the same thing if you don't count the vaginas.
Oof. I count them. Four. So far.
Okay, you know what, Mitch? It doesn't count if they have inflate nozzles.
Hey, look, man, it's not like, you know, you picked them up at, I don't know, ye olde cock and balls and got out the butter spray and the choke collar and the whole thing. I mean, you spent an afternoon together, right? I mean, obviously he likes you.
Right. Fuck. These are new.
What's the matter?
God damn it.
Are you cranky?
You know, I don't want to do this anymore. That's fine. That's great.
Yeah, okay. Well, you did a terrific job. Hey, listen, what are you doing on Friday night? You gonna go out with the guy?
I don't know. Why? Did Jackie say something?
I don't know, but if you come on Friday night, she can tell you herself.
Yeah, no, I'm not doing that. That's so seventh grade.
Well, you'll catch up. Huh?
Did she invite Tom?
No, it's just us. It'll be fine. 7 o'clock Friday night. All right?
All right.
Okay. All right.
All right, take this.
Okay, have a Valerian or something. Take a nap.
He's too intense. Yeah, you know, I like him as a friend, but...
Bullshit. That is just fear of intimacy, which, by the way, is so 1991. Pause. After you're giving and living life. Marie?
Yeah?
Put the headphones on. The headphones. There you go. Nice, Marie, but I need more smile and less sell, okay? Have fun.
Okay, great. Fun. All right. Good. Top notch. Thanks.
The way you did in the audition, remember? The reason we hired you?
Right. Absolutely. Yes. Good note. Really good note.
Great.
New Vita Power energy bars with tasty, chewy goodness in every bite.
Well, I'm just glad you met a guy with half a brain in his head.
Oh, wait, let me find the love in that. Oh, right, there is none.
Hey, I'm not the one who fell in love with a guy who could only get a job selling sperm samples and doing experimental drug research. Wasn't he allergic?
Yes, but he was cute and you know it.
Yeah, when the hives cleared up.
During and after your living and giving life.
Pause.
Sweetie?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
You're not Kathleen Turner, okay?
No, I'm not. I'm not Kathleen Turner. That's right. Yeah, I'm me. Is that what you're saying? I should be me.
No.
What I'm saying is that this isn't Blue Cross Blue Shield. It's an energy snack. So why don't we have some, I don't know, energy?
Energy, yes, of course. Okay, you're right. All right, because it's Vita Power, and Vita means life. Okay, now, all right, correct me if I'm wrong. My intention should be to give more life, except as a bar. But Jackie, my concern is that I'm going to be over the top.
No, honey, you're so under the top right now, it's like you're selling me a douche. Okay, I'm getting you on the beach in a floral print dress talking about feminine freshness. Is that the read you're going for?
No, that's not. Those were good word pictures. Okay, just translate them for what I need. Okay, good. Yeah, I can do this. I'm just gonna keep going.
You are so mean. You're not even listening to her.
Yes, I am. She thinks she's doing books on tape.
I think she's good.
Well, don't change the subject. Brett and I are cooking dinner on Friday night.
What are you having?
Shut up, you're coming.
Is he invited?
No, just you. Pause.
That's it, go home.
You want me to go? I should go home?
No, you're incredible. I mean, that voice, don't even kid yourself. You're gonna have a huge career.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Well, thanks to you.
Jackie's a piece of work.
Brett's a lying sack of shit. You look good.
I have no idea who this is. I'm gonna kill you. If this is a sports figure, I'm gonna kill you.
Jaleel White, TV's
no, up. No, no.
Like, Elie Wiesel!
Yeah, you're actually not my partner. Okay, come on, go. Go, go, go.
What is it about this look that makes you think I know?
Come on, all right, pass. Pass, pass, pass. Okay, this one, fuck, open. Okay, the ex-football player who allegedly killed his wife.
Oh. Allegedly, what are you, nuts?
Just say it!
O.J. Simpson.
Yes.
Okay. That's like saying Jackie allegedly got a nose job.
Shut up.
Both of you shut up, okay? All right, this one, the first name rhymes with this.
Okay, could you never, ever do that again?
Just say it.
Time.
Brett, is it maybe time? What the fuck was that?
Oh, I bet you it was one of Brad's. They're so hard because he's so smart.
Apparently not smart enough to know that he had a nose job.
What, I told you about that.
I did.
So what's the dev?
Come on, Brett, like you couldn't tell. Every Jewish teenage girl with money winds up with that nose.
So don't you think it's like a little bit weird though that everyone on the planet knows but your boyfriend?
Seriously, Eli, who was that?
Oh, okay, well I was doing the hula, so
I mean, it's a little strange. Right?
Okay. They used to call me the Jackal. Alright, so I got a nose job. Are you happy now?
All right. I give up. What rhymes with hula?
The Jackal.
That's brutal.
Hula.
Okay.
You're being a jerk.
Yep, but I'm being an honest jerk, so that counts for something.
Oh, wait! Shh! You hear that?
What's
you hear
that?
That's the sound of you not getting laid tonight.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's fun. Did you guys hear that? That was the sound of Jackie being a bitch.
Yeah. Did you guys hear that?
Yeah.
I did hear that.
What do you want from me?
I don't know. How about a little honesty? You know.
Oh, come on. You know what? The self-pity bus stops right in front of my building, pal. Don't miss it.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Well, maybe I'll get on the self-pity bus.
Okay,
you know,
why don't you?
Maybe I'll get a transfer.
Okay. You know what? Can we get out of here before they start looking like my parents?
Fine with me.
All right. Your place?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hey, was that Tallulah Bankhead?
No. Rula Lenska.
Rula Lenska. The fuck is Rula Lenska?
Guess they're made up.
Hope she paid for Scotchgard.
Oh, don't do that. No, not right now.
Well, like when people say et cetera instead of et cetera, what is that? Et cetera. It's crazy. Oh, my favorite is for all intensive purposes. That's like nuts. It's like, you know what? Where'd you go to school? Now, you sure you don't want a sandwich?
I mean, I don't know how you could eat that food. No offense, but Jackie can't cook for shit. No wonder Brett's losing weight.
Hey, Hollywood News, where's your section?
No, you don't have to.
No, come on, please.
It's embarrassing. God, I mean, it's, yeah. Don't.
Look at that police blotter, edited by Eli Wyckoff.
Yeah, I don't want you to.
Juan Amos, 35, arrested early Sunday for DUI. Blood alcohol level was 2.1 when suspect was apprehended by LAPD.
What?
It says apprehended.
No, it doesn't. It's apprehended.
It says apprehended.
Oh my God. Shit.
To apprehend, that's when what? They grab the guy on the ass?
God damn it, I proofread this like a million times. Oh, God.
Relax.
Fuck.
Do you know what you need?
Yeah, I have a new job, apparently.
No. You need a drink. A drink. A real drink. Do you have any vodka?
I don't know. Is this vodka? I've had it since, like, 1947.
All right, do you have martini glasses?
Those are my martini glasses. And my juice glasses and my water glasses.
All right, never mind, they'll do. I am gonna introduce you to the wonderful world of martinis. Screen.
No, let me go.
Come on, let the machine go.
No,
you know, I bet you can't do it.
I can do it.
I dare you. All right.
Hi, this is Eli. Leave a message.
I get the piece of shit machine
Eli,
fixed.
Eli, this is Dr. Wyckoff. There's something wrong with your machine.
Who's that, your shrink?
No, it's my mom. Money?
You refer to her?
It took her 12 years to get her PhD. She likes to hear herself say it. Okay, now move.
No.
No, come on.
Okay,
move. No, I'm serious.
Eli.
It's not funny.
I was just reading the New England Journal of Medicine, and there's a pull-out section on the new TSE testicular self-exam and how to make it part of your lifestyle.
My God.
This guy did the...
Do you want to try it?
No, come on. God damn it. I can't believe...
I faxed a diagram over to your office. I put your name all over it.
Oh my God.
Really,
yeah, don't listen.
You know what?
Don't listen.
The Hughes just... hit you right in the face. Okay, you may
want to
give yourself an exam while I read aloud.
Come on,
I think we should do this exam together.
Okay.
Okay, let's take a deep breath together. Okay. Start by lifting the penis to one side.
No, my God.
All right. Slowly roll the testicle between the thumb and fingers, applying slight pressure.
Ow! Hello? Mom? It's me.
Who?
Eli.
Eli. Oh, well, are we screening?
Yeah, no, I wasn't actually. We just got in.
We? Mm-hmm. Mm, what does that mean?
Can I call you back?
Do we have company?
Yes.
Jewish?
No, but...
Cute?
Will you stop?
Wear a condom.
Oh, God, Mom, no, it's not like...
You hear the stuff about the PSE? Did you hear what I was talking about?
Yeah, we both did. Thanks.
Maybe you could both do it together then. Nothing wrong with helping each other with a testicular exam.
Mom...
Don't be shy.
I gotta call you later, okay?
Wait, honey, please, hold on for a second. Call me tomorrow morning.
Goodbye.
Between 6:50 and 7.
God. I feel so dirty.
So, why does it matter if I'm Jewish?
You heard that?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. I am gonna go to the bathroom now and hope to God that I can overdose on Tums or Maalox or pine-scented Glade. I'm so embarrassed.
Don't be. It wasn't that bad, really. It's funny, actually.
Will you please call Mom for me? I cannot talk to her. The woman stopped having boundaries when she stopped wearing a bra. And the fact that I know that, ew.
I know. It's scary.
Did she pull that shit with you?
Are you kidding? She wanted me to tape my first time for her professional evaluation.
And?
I'm not telling you.
Oh, God, and did I tell you she just sent me this article about circle jerks and the new safe sex?
Can you believe I thought circle jerks was a figure skating term?
Well, you know, it is with the male figure skaters. Will you please call her for me? Please, I cannot talk to her.
You know, you can't fight it. And the more you try to avoid her, the more she's going to insist on meeting... What's your new boyfriend's name?
Tom, and he's not my boyfriend.
Whatever.
I don't know what the hell he is.
Well, what do you want him to be?
What? I just wish I knew one way or the other.
Okay, put the bong down, Space Cowboy. He's your fucking boyfriend, just like I said.
Eli.
You and nudity.
Nothing, but that movie was pandering.
It was an art film.
Yeah, the art of guys with six-pack abs blowing each other every chance they get. And every gay guy in LA is like, run, don't walk. And the problem with that is...
Christ, you may as well stay home and watch The Hand That Rocks My Ladle or Pocahontas Show. At least those movies don't pretend to be something that they're not.
You have those? Pop them in.
Oh, God. See, you're part of the problem.
Let me get this straight. You think that a movie about two guys that can't be about love, just sex?
Those guys were in love. Grant, it was a special kind of love. The kind of love that required latex.
Oh my God. You know what? Never mind. I cannot have this argument with a guy who never saw Gone with the Wind. What is that?
God, would you relax? Huh? You're gonna give yourself an aneurysm.
You are infuriating.
You don't have to.
Do you want me to stop?
No. Man, you always smell so good.
Okay, there you go. So, Saturday, it's tennis, right? Must be an open on.
Australia, British,
Pakistani, right?
Is something wrong?
What? No, I just want to watch TV, that's all.
Huh. It's okay, whatever, I get it.
Get what?
Same as usual, right? The whole come here, go away routine.
What, do you want me to keep massaging you? I will, but I gotta tell you, this isn't exactly the way to get me to want to.
No, Tom, it's actually fine. You know, that's just, you're not attracted to me, you wanna just be friends, I can handle that. But then stop fucking calling me and inviting me to go see semi-porn on a Saturday afternoon. And then drag me back to my house and start rubbing my shoulders and expect me to be like, hey buddy, thanks a lot, I'll see you around.
What is so wrong with taking things slow? Huh? Why does it always have to be all or nothing with you?
I don't know.
All right, fine, then maybe we should cool it off for a while. No, I like you, I do.
Thank you. Well,
I just wanna have a good time. That's all. I don't want to make this intense thing. And you seem to want this. I don't know. What do you want?
Eggs, actually.
Whatever.
Remember cooties? Don't touch the losers or you get cooties. And who are the losers? Easy. Anybody with a hard-boiled egg in their lunch bag. Well, I don't think Tom liked what I had in my lunch bag.
What about sex? I mean, people do have sex.
Sex is a logical outgrowth.
Eli, let it out.
No, you know, I don't want to talk about it.
Cop out!
Why do you feel the need to beat yourself up?
Why won't you let us into the now?
Why do I feel like I'm in a cheesy 70s Est seminar?
Good. How else do you feel?
Would you like us to bring out the feel wheel?
You know what? No, I would actually like it if you'd just leave me alone for a little while.
Let me in. I'm not going to hurt you. I'm your friend. What is wrong?
I'm fine, okay?
I don't think so.
It's this guy.
I knew it.
He has this reputation for being sort of easy.
Mm-hmm.
Not with me. With me, it's hard.
Or not hard, maybe that's the problem. Okay. Oh, Eli, what is this?
...outed by a former student on the night of the Academy Awards. The groundbreaking comedy starring Kevin
I
Klein.
Hate this film. David, come in here. You won't believe what they're showing again. What a piece of shit film, honestly. Like, we're supposed to believe this. Look at this. They're showing it again. That this woman's going to fall in love with a middle-aged, homophobic, self-hating teacher who's only now discovered he's gay.
We hated this movie.
I don't think so.
Change the channel.
Fuck you!
Hi, Sunny.
Oh, honey. That's so sweet. But right now, the thought of food makes me want to borch. Pretty picture to wake up to, huh?
Well, A, I can't imagine waking up to any other picture. And B, I don't ever want to have to.
What is this?
It's your capers. I know how you like them on the side. Special.
Oh my God. Oh my god. Oh shit. Oh, no, 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 no. Of course I'll marry you. It's just that now everybody's gonna think we're doing it because I'm pregnant.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Mr. Peggers. Mr. Peggers. Wake up, Mr. Peggers.
We should have never fooled around.
I know. Why don't you have some more wine?
What can I say? It doesn't make me weak in the knees.
Please, that is exactly why you should be with him. I mean, the ones that make you dizzy are only good for a quick fuck. The rest are marriage material. Like Brett.
That is exactly what I'm afraid of. Wait, what? Wow. Wow, that was fast.
A little TikTok, you know?
You're crazy.
I want you to be my man of honor.
There's no such thing.
So? You're my best friend. I couldn't even imagine anybody else by my side. And your first duty as my personal slave is to pretend to love it.
Fine, fine.
Thanks. I love you.
I've been walking backwards lately to see if I can find you. Still
it's Jackie.
Your old
again.
Sometimes
hello. Where are you?
You
call me back,
through.
Dad.
Imagine you're falling asleep watching TV in the dam. If I could bring you back, talk about everything.
Hi, this is Tom. Leave a message or don't.
This is the bride-to-be.
I really wouldn't mind having my best friend around right now.
Being that it's the most important time of my life. But hey, maybe that's just
too much to ask for.
Just to see your face again. And just to make you smile. Would set me free. If I be the sweetest thing if I could bring you back to me.
Jack, pick up, it's me. Jackie, please pick up. All right, well, I met someone. Apparently.
Fuck.
Listen, Jack, I'm really sorry I haven't returned your calls. I've been a shit, all right? And it's me, it's not you. Like you don't know that. Jack, I really, really need to talk to you, all right? I'm freaking out here. Oh, Jesus, this guy has the number 8 tattooed on his... Wait. Correction, it says 8th Wonder. Okay, yeah, you know, I really know how to pick him. Jack, please call me back.
Open your eyes and look at me. No, I don't think I will kiss you. Although you need kissing badly. The right moment ever again.
You're a conceited, black-hearted, vomit-red button. I don't know why I let you come and see me.
I'll tell you why, Scarlet. War can't last much longer.
Really, Red? Why?
There's a little battle going on right now.
Hello?
How you been?
Okay.
Good.
Listen,
What?
Well, what I was gonna say was is I've been procrastinating about this whole wedding thing. I mean, I haven't gotten a gift for Jackie's shower yet. I guess I'm in denial.
Sure, it's not the first time.
Yeah, right.
You know, Tom, I guess I never got the email, you know, that our cooling off period was officially over, and frankly, I'd like to renew my option.
Yeah.
Bye. Hi, this is Eli. Leave a message. Yeah, it's Tom again. Listen,
now
I'm all for keeping
now he's
things
fucking
casual, but
that's
doesn't
just
mean
great.
We can't go
that's
out and buy a baby gift together, does it?
I hate people like this. You know, they play this game. Once you decide to play too, they don't want to play anymore. I mean, what the fuck is that?
Yeah, you know, I'm starting to think that's all there is out there anymore.
No, that's wrong.
No, you know, here's what I think. I think who I am, you know, what I've been, not working so much anymore. From now on, there's going to be a whole new Eli. The whole love thing, I don't buy it.
Well, how come it works for me?
Oh my God, you are so full of shit. It doesn't work for you. You fall in love with a different person each week.
My point exactly.
No. You fall in love with the idea of being in love. With a married man to what, like experience the rush of breaking up a family? Then you fall in love with a deaf guy to learn sign language?
Well, I did.
Okay, honey, this does not constitute sign language. And then with a woman just to piss off mom and dad.
Okay, how much did that backfire? That's the year that they decided to run for co-president of PFLAG.
You know what? From now on, it's just gonna be one night stands, casual sex, just a lot of close friends.
Ugh, you sound pathetic.
No, you know what? For the first time in my life, I think I actually make sense.
Great. Glad to help you through the pain. Bye-bye.
Bye. I'll call you later.
Yeah, will you tell that other Eli to give me a call? This one sucks.
If that's him, you're not going shopping.
Okay, FYI, the only reason I'm here is because your whole tires got slashed story was so much more believable than the first 13 messages you left me.
Personally, I thought I had you with the tickets to X-Files on Ice.
I already saw it.
I always wanted one when I was a kid. Surprising, huh?
Oh my God, I had so many dolls.
My dad would have killed me.
Really?
Yeah.
My house was like a free-for-all. My sister had all these Barbies and Kens, and my parents made me play with them.
Your parents forced you to play with dolls?
Oh, it was just so I could learn the names of all the body parts.
Pick whichever doll you like. It's your choice. They're all beautiful. Good. Now switch. What do you call this?
Vagina.
Yes,
Vagina. Good, Rena. Eli? Vagina.
Vagina.
Now say it like you mean it. Vagina.
Vagina.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I always thought Ken was gay.
Was when I got through with him. That's another story.
You know, you and Ken together, it's strangely erotic.
Well, we have been known to do private shows, if you're interested.
Not today.
Okay.
Hello there, Eli. I'm Fuzzy Wuzzy the Bear.
Jackie would love this bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a bear. Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy. Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he?
Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he? Was he?
That's what I said.
No, no. You said, was he? It's was he.
What's the difference?
You're kidding, right? You just established that Fuzzy Wuzzy had no hair. Why would you then ask, was he? Like a question. Like you didn't know if he was fuzzy or not.
It is a question. I'm asking if Fuzzy is or isn't fuzzy. What is so wrong about that?
It is a rhetorical question. There's no answer to it. It's supposed to be ironic. Fuzzy Wuzzy wasn't very fuzzy. Was he?
I don't think it's that obvious if Fuzzy Wuzzy was or wasn't fuzzy.
It is the point of the whole goddamn thing.
Man, why are you so uptight? No, there always has to be a right way with you and a wrong way with you. I mean, is that why you like being with me? So you can feel like you're right all the time?
What? No. Is that what you think?
All I know is you have this rigid idea of how I should be.
All's you know?
Fuck.
Opponents! Mine!
Well, enjoy it now, hon, because in a month or so, you're gonna be ripping scenes.
Okay. I'm gonna kill you.
Rachel, could you shut the fuck up? You're cackling like an idiot.
Come on, Liz, grab some bows and help us with the rehearsal bouquet.
Well, why do you want me to do it? Because you think it's the only time I'm ever going to get to hold one?
Okay, Liz, what time is therapy, hon? Do they make house calls?
That's really sweet. Very supportive. Taking my gift back.
I'll make it.
Thank you.
Nice person.
Wait! The door! Get the door!
Oh. Is Jackie here?
Hey, Jackie. Did you forget to pay some parking tickets?
Hello.
Are you Jackie Gold?
I'll be Jackie Gold.
I'm gonna kill you guys. I can't believe you did this.
Jackie, you have been a bad, bad, bad girl, haven't you?
Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Put that thing away. We're gonna post it.
Okay, that is gonna be amazing.
Enough with the pictures.
It was great.
Diana with the pictures.
One more. No. Ah, ring. Ring.
Okay.
Okay, wait. Forget about the ring. Can we talk about our friend the cop?
Oh, you mean your future ex-husband?
Please.
So how long have you been doing this?
Can you imagine? Yummy.
You're a great ass. Anyway. Let's go, ladies.
Let me ask you this. How many of these gifts can I take home with me?
You're crazy.
I wrap beautifully, though.
Well, don't
you think you should share?
What are you gonna do with, like, baby gifts?
You don't even like mine. Can I take it back?
Excuse me, one second.
So, you know, I've been kind of bad myself.
You have.
Look.
forgive me if I act a little strange. For I know not what I do. Feels like lightning running through my veins every time I look at you. Every time
hey.
I look
hey.
At you.
How much do I owe
you? 922.
Why don't you keep that?
Cool.
Thanks a lot.
Have a good night.
You too. Thanks.
There's so much I want to say. Want to tell you just how good it feels when you look at me.
Hey. Where did you find this?
Internet.
Thank you.
I took it out of the box so you could play with it.
It came in a box? The original box?
Mm-hmm.
Where is it?
I tossed it. Why? Why?
Never mind.
And then it happened. We went where no two men should ever go without a prescription.
Trust me, you don't want the details.
Are you nuts? At my age, the details are all I got. Whoa,
whoa, whoa. Oh, take off your...
Ouch.
I'm hungry.
Yeah? You like eggs? Why don't I make us some eggs?
Well, I'm supposed to meet my parents at the country club for brunch. Do you want to come? Hey.
Hi, Mom.
Hi,
how are
you?
Hey, Dad.
Mom.
This is Eli.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
Hello, Eli.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Well, why don't we all sit down? Lydia and I can share a menu.
I'll get another setup. Do you guys want coffee or juice or anything?
Yeah, coffee with milk.
Can I get a mimosa and a coffee? And a water?
You'll fill up on liquids, honey. Save room for your meal.
Leave him alone, Lydia.
I wasn't criticizing
him.
He's
obviously
just...
old enough to please himself.
Yeah. So, what have you guys been up to?
Well, not much, really. We got back from Keenan on Friday, and, And then I took the girls from my church group to see Phantom of the Opera.
Oh, is that still running?
It was Friday night.
Right. I didn't know.
Yeah, $75 a shot. It's absurd. It's like throwing money in the trash.
It's theater, Jim.
It's trash, Lydia.
All right. But how was it up at Keenan? What's wrong?
Now's not the time, honey.
So, what, there's a right time to ask about Amy?
stupid.
Excuse me.
You heard me, Lydia.
You talk to me like that, you'll see what you get from me.
Is that a threat, Lydia?
Dad, could you not...
Shut up, Tom.
Oh, that's rich.
Let's go. Come on, let's go.
Let go of me. Don't do... Don't do that. Get your hands off me. Get your...
I told you. Do it now.
You always do this. You always pull a scene.
Let's go.
Tom. Tom, the valet is that way.
I'm not ready. If you want to go, I'll take a cab.
It's a nice club. You think if I were half Jewish, they'd let me halfway in the pool? I'm really sorry.
You didn't do anything.
Who's Amy?
She's my sister.
What? I didn't know you had a sister.
Okay. I have a sister, Amy. She lives up north at a special needs facility.
Was she in an accident?
No. No. FAS, do you know what that is? Fetal alcohol syndrome. Any other questions?
Hey, pal, I'm on your side, remember?
I don't want anyone on my side, remember? You think just because we fucked, that makes us a we? I didn't ask for this, for you. Just stop.
You called me, remember? So make up your fucking mind.
How many ways do you need to be told to leave me the fuck alone?
You know what, asshole? Just one.
All I know is if I wasn't loaded half the time, I probably wouldn't be in this mess.
Don't you feel like the older you get, the less you really know about anything?
Absolutely. I don't know shit. People think just because I managed to make it to 60 without getting a Colombian necklace or run over by a UPS truck that I have the answers to life's questions.
Great. So there's no hope?
Oh, don't do that. See, I'm not that deep shock Oprah, or whatever the hell he calls himself, who tells you you believe in yourself, you can do anything. Pish. All's I know is you keep your two eyes on your own paper and both hands on the wheel. And a multivitamin can't hurt.
So I guess the lesson's the same with booze as it is with guys, wanting it and having it. Totally not the same thing. I'll be right back. Bathroom.
Sometimes I think you can want it and have it. But now what happens now?
Now? Oh, what do you mean about Eli being at the wedding?
It's not that now.
Oh, wait a minute.
You make me wait too long. Think too much, buddy.
Told you. Negative.
Great.
So I guess that's it.
Nice meeting you.
Oh, you're gonna be seeing a lot more of me, you'll see. You know, now that I'm off relationships and just doing one-night stands.
Yeah, sure. Take a condom. I used to put candy in this.
Anyway, sorry I talked your ear off.
Oh, please. It's better than a fucking movie, sweetheart. Oh, don't you need a parking validation?
Oh, my God, right. Thank you. Thanks.
Oh, wait a second. Feedback clinic, this is Esther. Oh, hi, honey. How you doing? What? No, what? Go ahead, ask me. What? Well, I'm not a mind reader. You ever see me on the fucking Psychic Friends Network channel? So, what? All right, would you just shut up for a minute? Okay, so don't tell me.
Trust me, Esther, one night stands.
It's all black and white for you, isn't it?
What?
I have been married to that Putz for 42 years. The strongest, healthiest man all his life. And all of a sudden, he gets sick. Lung cancer. He never smoked a day in his life. Pretty fucking ironic, isn't it? He even got someone taking care of him in the afternoon. Just like a little boy. But he's dying. And if I stop hocking him and giving him shit, call him an asshole, he'll know he's dying. So I don't stop. Plus, he is an asshole. So that's a bonus.
So, I've got my grandmother's ring that's old and borrowed, and Rachel got me that blue thong.
Ooh, hoochie floss.
Well, you got something else that's new and blue?
Oh, actually, yeah, I do.
Holy shit, Tom, what happened?
Bad date.
What'd you do, pick him up on the street?
Worse, AA. Apparently he uses sex to work through anger, which is fine when you're not quite that angry.
What am I gonna do with you?
I smell a lecture.
Fuck you, Tom. Okay, you blow off a great guy who, by the way, doesn't hit because he made the tragic mistake of falling for you, and instead you're doing Ike and Tina Turner with some asshole from AA.
Well, you know, at least he's not at Williams-Sonoma registering for our commitment ceremony.
You're right. You're right. Eli is such a loser. I'm going home.
No, I'm nervous about seeing Tom at the wedding, that's all.
See, only you could turn my wedding day into the Eli Wyckoff show. You know that?
I'm sorry, okay? Believe me, nobody can hate me as much as I do.
Oh my God, you know, you have to change the fucking record, man. You have to stop. You cannot make this be the be-all, end-all of your entire life.
Yeah, I'm not.
Yeah, that's exactly what you're doing. Let me tell you something. Love, right? It's gonna come up, and it's just gonna whack you on the back of the head before you even know it.
I don't believe that.
What are you talking about? What happened to me and Jackie?
Yeah, well, you and Jackie were lucky.
What? You know, you're unbelievable. I was miserable before I met her, and it just happens, you know? I mean, you're a fucking amazing guy.
You don't have to do this.
Please shut up. You're a great guy, you know? I mean, if I were in the guys, we'd be in China right now picking out a baby. Thank God I'm not, but kidding. You know I love the gays.
And we appreciate it.
Guys?
Mitch?
I don't know if it's just me, but love it.
You like the tux?
Loving it.
Yeah, Mitch, remember how we discussed the Ritalin situation? Just please put on your pants. Or get a tan.
Get doubles. I want all of these.
Oh, yeah. When my sister got married, the best pictures were, like, from the Instamatics.
Your sister got married?
Yes.
Jesus fuck, what is my problem? I'm like man poison. Fucking penis raid.
Oh,
whatever. Okay, girls. How do I look?
Oh my God.
You look like a movie star.
Really?
Yes.
Totally hot. Oh, seriously.
Oh, Christ. In a million years, I never thought I'd be wearing white this soon.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't be. Unless you want me to call the Pope and tell him it happened again.
I would have worn the cream one, except for it made me look like a Jenny Craig before picture.
What? Are you crazy?
Hey, where's Tom?
Yeah, he's out on the patio. I mean, he is a man after all.
What?
Repellent, remember? Gay or straight, doesn't matter.
Hey, put that out. You're killing my unborn child.
I was aiming a little higher.
Oh, nice. What are you doing out here?
Oh my God, Eli was stalking you? That is so romantic.
Well, not to me.
Oh, that's right. But if he tried to kill you, then you'd be picking out China patterns. Are you all right?
Yeah. Just
You're getting married. I'm having abandonment issues.
I'm just extending the family, babe.
Jackie, let's go.
We'll be right there.
Tom, I owe you an apology.
For what?
The way I've been pressuring you about Eli. And I realize I've just been trying to make you like everybody else, and you're not. And that's one of the things I love about you. You're the only guy I know who will probably never find that one person to settle down with and still be very happy. I envy that.
Jackie, get your ass in here or I'm wearing the veil.
We're coming. But look at me. Shit. I'm like one step away from den mother, PTA, and hi, honey, I'm home. How the fuck did that happen?
Guess you fell in love.
What? Oh, no, 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 I just got lipstick all over every single one of my teeth. How did I do that?
All right. Well, it's showtime.
You may exchange the rings.
Wow, that's a nice one. We're renting the place.
Congratulations. I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Eli.
Yeah?
How long are we gonna have to keep ignoring each other?
What? I'm not ignoring you. Are you ignoring me?
Come on, Eli. You haven't returned one of my phone calls, and you've said maybe three words to me the entire day, two of which were Seafood Newberg.
Which I have to say was repulsive.
Can I get some more champagne? Champagne?
No. Can I get a...
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. Absolute martini, straight up, two olives, make it dirty.
No, no. Actually, seltzer with lime, please.
So now you're not drinking? Wow. Good for you.
Thanks. I sort of had to. I was slipping in the polls.
Yeah, well... I, on the other hand, need some more champagne.
Look, Eli, I'm sorry, you know what?
Let's not do any of that. I'm sorry it didn't work out, post-mortem stuff, okay?
Okay.
Besides, that'll free up some time to make fun of people. Like Mitch, man of mystery, teaching the rabbi the Macarena. What is this, 1987?
Did you see Brett's mom? I've never seen a woman with more hair on her back.
I know. I keep waiting for the anti-fur activists to storm in here and throw paint on her.
Poor Brett and Jackie. They have no idea what they got themselves into, but they will, mark my words. See, first they'll only hang out with other couples, you know, and then they'll start doing the we thing. Oh, we love this and we hate that. And ordering for each other because that's what we always have. Before you know it, she'll be shopping for lingerie at Bloomingdale's, and Brett, the poor loser, will be outside the dressing room with her pocketbook in his lap.
Oh my God. You are so full of shit, you know that? You've got this bullshit, I don't need anyone thing. And you use that, thinking it's gonna shield you from the fact that your parents were drunks, had a lousy marriage, and fucked up everyone in their lives. But it's your life now, not theirs. And what do you have to show for it? You're just another self-hating, recovering alcoholic with nothing to live for but a martini and a blowjob.
Eli. Eli. Hey! Don't you dare sum me up. You don't know the first thing about me.
And that would be whose fault?
Oh, God. God. You know what? It's so easy for you, Mr. Love is a many splendored thing. But you know what? I've seen it. I've seen it. My parents loved one another till death do us part. And believe me, it practically came to that. I mean, have you ever heard the sound of two people suffocating one another? Have you? Or the sound of ice cubes smashing against the wall or a pot roast being shoved down the disposal? No. How could you possibly with your touchy-feely, I'm okay, you're okay parents? I'm sorry, I'm bursting your little bubble. But there are a million guys out there who can give you what you want. I'm just not one of them. I'm sorry. You do the math. You know what? Fuck you, if that's the wrong use of that expression.
I just wanted to say before I go, I'm sorry. I don't want you to leave here today thinking that you can't do this. Because you can. Tom, you are gonna meet someone and you're gonna be so great at this. And it's not gonna be like your parents, and it's not gonna be like it was with me. Anyway, I'll see you around.
Eli.
What exactly do you want? What do I?
Yeah. You.
I wanted for this to stop being so fucking hard. I want to meet your sister. I want to be over this part, you know, so I can call you an asshole, even when you're sick and you'd still know how much I love you.
Eli.
I don't know what you call that, Tom. Pocketbook holding, suffocating, maybe. But if I could ever have anything even close to that. So I'm gonna go, okay? Valet's got my car.
Hey, there you are. Oh, Eli, hey.
Hey.
Should I, or is everything okay?
Yeah. What's up with the braid?
Oh, Brett did it. It's a long story. Okay, I need to take a personal moment.
What's the matter? You not having fun?
Oh, I was till about 5 minutes ago.
What happened?
I put my left foot in, I put my left foot out, I put my left foot in, and then I threw up.
The baby?
No. Brett's cousin Al bumped his pokey into my hokey, and I borched, all right? I think Brett is the only normal person in that family.
Yeah.
Okay, can we talk about his brother, Mitch? Hello, oh Freaky God. McFreak.
I know. You know, the guy wants to get into Cirque du Soleil. I swear to you, he says he can swallow his own leg.
Ew. Well, yo, what's up? How you doing?
What am I missing?
Oh, just a family resemblance. And I love you for it.
Okay. Well, I don't know what that means. I'm really smashed. Can I tell you? I think I just made out with the rabbi. Is that?
He is hot.
Is he going to be dancing? Are we going to dance? Because I promised the family some hot man-on-man action tonight.
You and me?
No.
I think he means me.
Don't worry. Yeah. Come on, guys. Let's go. It's going to be fun. Come on, sweetheart. Oh, look at that ass. A little something like that. Or if you like, we could do 80s style. No? Come on. Start like that. And then maybe a little...
Ow. Ow. I was slipping on my foot.
That was that replaced hip I got.
How hot does this broad look tonight?
So I meant to tell you, I finally saw Gone with the Wind. And? And I loved it. Oh, thank God. See, I think Scarlett realizes in the end that it was just fear holding her back from the guy that she wanted to, you know, hold her pocketbook. Yeah. And the thing about Rhett Butler?
Yeah.
He wasn't very fuzzy, was he? I'm gonna make you love me. I'm gonna dry your tears. And we're gonna stay together for a million years. It's the least I can do. Just to make you my baby.
Treetops, the wind is whistling through the mountain's teeth.